in the name of the greatest people that have ever trod this earth, I draw the line in the dust and toss the gauntlet before the feet of tyranny, and I say segregation now, segregation tomorrow, and segregation forever.
Keep on pushing. Keep on pushing. I've got to keep on pushing. I can't stop now.
50 years ago, a great American in whose symbolic shadow we stand today signed the Emancipation Proclamation.
I open my mouth to the Lord and I won't turn back. I will go, I shall go to see what the end's gonna be.
Whoa, who's that yonder dressed in red?
This nation will rise up, live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will they be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood? I have a dream. My four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. Let freedom ring, and if America is to be a great nation, this must become true. So let freedom ring. From the prodigious hilltops of New Hampshire, let freedom ring. From the mighty mountains of New York, when we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and singing the words of the old Negro spiritual, free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
Shall go,
will go,
shall
just
go
to see what the end's gonna be
in the morning,
to see what the end's gonna be
in the evening,
to see what the end's gonna be
night hour.
Sir, do you expect more Negro support here than Senator McCarthy in California?
I just hope that I have widespread support.
Every American, no matter what his background, what his creed, what color of his skin, or where he lives, shall walk with dignity and honor in the United States.
I think every man is entitled to find a job. I think every man is entitled to raise his family in an area where they have decent schools.
Without a decent home, without an environment of quality, our hopes for our children are merely illusions.
Robert Kennedy, when he was Attorney General, said that he could imagine the possibility of a Negro president in the United States within perhaps 40 years. Do you think this is at all realistic?
Well, let me say first that I think it is necessary to make it clear that there are Negroes who are presently qualified to be president of the United States. There are many who are qualified in terms of integrity, in terms of vision, in terms of leadership.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain inalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you very much. Thank you, everybody. To Chairman Dean
and my great friend, Dick Durbin, and to all my fellow citizens of this great nation, with profound gratitude and great humility, I accept your nomination for presidency of the United States.
Coming up, and the world is in their hands.